Hi, everyone. It's Cindy with Chess Girl Vegas. Hey, it's Sunday night, 9:34. We got 97 degrees where I live. I thought I would play a quick game of chess. And then I want to do an episode about Beth Harmon. The chess, you know, great. Okay, so I'm playing as white. I'm going to move the king's pawn. I'm playing someone from Brazil. Brazil has a lot of players. Okay, so this person plays rapid and blitz. Okay. So, yeah, I'm going to have to watch my time with this person. Alright, I'm going to bring my knight up. Let's see what happens. I like these little copper mugs. My husband got me a couple. They're nice. Okay. So if I go there, it's probably going to go there. I might bring my knight out. Sicilian defense, close, traditional line. Okay. Yeah, we got some pizza, and the dogs are just like, they love pizza. They're trying to get the pieces of pepperoni. We give them a little, not too much. Bring that there for a second. We can always maybe go right here if the knight moves. I could go up here. Huh. Okay. Yeah. Well. Okay. I think it's going to tell me to attack. I should get castled pretty soon. Rhinosauro. Sounds like a dinosaur, right? Rhinosauro. Okay. So, yeah, I'm forced to take. Otherwise, it's going to take my bishop. Oh, I could have put the king in check. That actually might have been a good move. Let's do this. I'm sure they'll block with the bishop. They won't block with the queen. Yeah, clear some space. Get castled. Connect my queen and my rook. Push this up one. This bishop comes out. Attack this knight. We won't have any knights on the board. We'll make for some interesting chess. Where are you gonna go? You could go back there. You could go there. I guess you could go there. Okay. I like the idea of doing that. I know this pawn was guarding this pawn, but I do have the knight behind it. I want to kind of block this. Okay, black just castled on move 13, king side. We've both castled on the same side of the board. I castled on the ninth move. I'm playing as white. We both have about 27 minutes on the clock. Kind of like this. Attack that rook. Yeah, now there's two. Get my rooks connected. Yeah, so black's up one right now. This queen comes this way. Okay. Well, so if the queen comes down, what would I do? Would I take? If I don't take, it's going to take this and then this, and I take back. It could get pretty ugly. Okay. Do I have any better move?
Hey, what are you doing?
If I go here, could go there. That might be a nice move. I should drop that down. Could be a big blunder, what I just did, but I'm just trying something. Let's see what they do. Can always bring this rook here. Or guard this. Might just take this. If it takes this pawn, I'm going to take back with the queen. Okay, got an apple. Let's see what Brazil does. I've actually lost some matches to the players from Brazil. They play pretty good chess. Geppetto, shh. Excuse me. Come on. Come on. Are you coming in? Yeah, this would be pretty tricky to win. Yeah, took that. Okay. Okay, well, this rook was going to be blocked. So I'm going to take this. That's a nice move too. Attack the queen right there. Give it like a bad angle. Could attack it with this. Right now she's gonna go there. So I go there. I go there. Let's just try it. This rook can't come down. That king's in check. Okay. We're gonna go here. go up here. Create an escape square. Okay. Go there. I think it's gonna take. See if it takes with the queen. If it doesn't take with the queen, I'm taking it. Okay, it went there. All right. Interesting. No. Yeah, this is probably going to be hard. Hard to win. See. See what happens. That's all we can do. All we can do is see what happens. Okay. Now it's up there. Go there. Could go there. Sort of like where I was, though, but this pawn's getting in my way. I'm gonna go that way. That might be, no. So that happens. Okay, let me see if my dog has calmed down enough to come back in. Okay. G. Come on. Geppetto. Stay out, Lance. Where's Geppetto? Here he comes. Lance, stay out. Okay, is it my move? Nope. Okay. So we're on move 22. I started as white. My opponent's playing black. They're from Brazil. They're called Rhinosauro, rated 939. They have a good, pretty good rating for blitz and bullet. So they obviously play rapid blitz and, you know, they play the different games. Hmm. Is there any move I'm missing? Yeah, that's almost a way in. It is a way if I had a rook underneath me. Yeah, we'll trade off. Yeah, this is gonna be a hard game to win. I'm not up. Now I got two pawns that are gonna come down and storm me. Yeah, well. Go here. Okay, he took that. All right. Take this one, maybe. Happens here if I take this pawn. So my opponent has six pawns, I have three. I'm down 3 points. I've obviously made some bad trades. Okay, this is coming across. It's coming down. Somehow I have to get to where I can defend that square, which I think this is a pretty good move right here. Is there anything I have here? Yeah, I kind of have something here. Could go there. Yeah, I don't know that it's enough. I was thinking right here, like, what would that cause? It would come down, probably. And I would go up. And then the king would have to go there. And I don't think there's much way I could infiltrate that. Alright, I'm just going back here. Guarding that and that. I think I want to push this one up too. Okay. Could go there. Wow. How do you calculate this? I do this. I want to see what this queen does. Where's this queen gonna go? So yeah, we're on move 27. Okay, it's gonna take attack it here. I think I should go here, but so I'm going here. Screw it. My king's on the second rank, so even if it takes, it's blocking its own pawn promotion. And I want to try to get this piece, this rook, and put this king in check somehow. And just keep trying to chase it down. Or to get a piece. Yeah, it came down. Okay. It came down. Yeah, see, if I could have taken it, I could have put the king in check. Okay, that's not good. It didn't work out too well. Well, could go here. It's basically game over. That's no good. That's no good. Yeah, there's no move. Yeah, the only hope I have is to do this. Put the king in check from right there. You can't take me just yet because you're in check. And then I'm going to take you. Take you. Check again. Well, at least I'm making it interesting, everybody. Don't go down without a fight on these matches. Yeah, I'm like one piece. One or two pieces usually from winning when I'm playing better people. I'm pretty close. So, probably going to push this down. Yep, I thought it would do that. Well, take this. I could take that, or it could go there, but then the queen would just get me. So I'm just gonna take this. Yeah, they should probably go here and attack me. That's what I would do. But then I could take it. Yeah, definitely have to work the angles on this. Why'd you go there? Why'd you go there? Gonna go over there. Yeah. What happens now? Okay. Well, too bad. Too bad. That would have been nice right there. Forking the queen. Forking the king and the queen, but unfortunately I don't have anything. Could put the king in check there. Then the queen's gonna go. Yeah, that's no good. That's no good. That's no good. Can't give up this queen. Shoot. No way to get any of this. No way to get that. If I go there, the king just takes, or the queen takes. From there, can't go there. Thank you. go there. See, where you go, queen? Huh. You really wanted to do that, huh? You do that. Yeah, you won. Good game. Good game, Brazil. You guys play good. Good game. Good game. Okay. Yeah. I gave it my best. Wow, my opponent had 91% accuracy. I mean, dang, that's pretty darn good. I only had one mistake this game. Wow. Yeah, it says, intense, tough game, your opponent played well. That's the truth. Good game, man. Okay, he's doing the fast moves again. I'm just curious, what's the mistake I made? Yeah, you guys probably don't want to see the whole game. I mean, what could I have done here? So I would have had to gone here, right? Then maybe what? Yeah, take. You know, yeah, there's no winning this game. Okay. That's kind of crazy, though, that that was my first mistake. That's a really well-played game for me. I mean, even though I lost, it's pretty well-played. You know? I mean, 91.3% accuracy and 44 moves. Who is this person? Has this person been playing since the time of the dinosaurs, or what? Rhino? A rhinosauro? Maybe he's a he or she is a scientist. But look, 91% accuracy. That's dang good. I mean, I had good accuracy. 79.6 is pretty good for me. I'm telling you, these players from Brazil, they know how to play. They know how to play. All the ones I've played have played really well. Oh, we want to see what it's saying. Want the game review. Show you guys the game review real quick. Okay, so I opened. So it's the Sicilian defense. Guard that, this pawn's guarding the square. A blunder and an inaccuracy. Could have gone here. What do I think about that? Yeah, so that was a good move. I thought about doing that. It just seems like every time I try to do this fork right here, I get, you know, a little stymied. Maybe because that pawn was there, the queen couldn't have done that. Yeah, I don't even think I'm going to go through that game. That is very accurate. If you want, I'll go through it super fast. Yeah, and so now I'm blocked. Yeah. See? I can't get there. Yeah, it's dead even right here. Knight to g5. Is an inaccuracy. Yeah, didn't like this move. It said to castle. It said to just castle. And what if I do this? Do I just take? Take with the queen? Take with the pawn? Probably take with the queen. Yeah, that's best. Okay, getting back to our game. I'll just go through these for you guys. So I know Nelson at Chess Vibe said, look for things that cause the eval bar to go. Okay, so it didn't like this move at all. Yeah, I didn't like this move. This was a bad move for me right here. Let's retry it. How could I have prevented my king from castling? Oh, right here. Yeah. Wait. Yeah, no, this one. Yep, I should have gone there. See the king? See this white bishop that's on the dark squares? It's controlling this, and the king cannot castle through a check. And that's considered a check, even though he's not in check right now. But it would be a check. So he can't do it. Okay, you BH5. This is the H file. This is, BH6. It's a 6. You prevented your opponent from castling, which can generate tactical opportunities by keeping the king in the center. Okay. Something I gotta be aware of. Try to not let the king castle when you can. We've already gone that far. We're going to close that one out. Okay. Let's go to the next key move. Wow, it's really going fast. Yeah. You overlooked a chance to win material. So, what was my chance to win material? Yeah, I was gonna do that. I thought I did that in the next move. Well, let's see what happens if we do it here. This is the start of the end game and you're losing. Yep. Yep, I know that. Yeah, I went there to put the king in check. But I'm down 14. So if I go there, what am I down? 10. Until they take back, then I'm back down again, probably a lot. Yeah, down 12. All right, they like that, attacking that king. Good. Okay, like that. Yeah, I didn't like this move. What's the best move here? Discarding this pawn. Guarding this square. Okay, if the queen moved there, I'd take it with the king. Okay, I understand that now. So if the queen takes, I'll get it. I'll get the, you know, if the black queen takes the white pawn on g2, I'll take. If the queen goes here, I'll take. If it goes here, I'll take. If it goes here, I'll take. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty good, trying to protect this area. Yeah. All right. Wow. You overlooked an opportunity. Well, what was the best move? Yeah. Oh, I could have won this pawn. Show line. Yeah, still not a way to win. It's not enough material against a rook and a pawn that's about to become a queen. Okay. Alright, I'm going to wrap that up. I do want to see if Beth Harmon is in this library. Oh yeah, games database. So you can search for openings. See advanced. I wanted to look for a name. Look, they're not even alphabetized. Shoot. Alright, I don't want to waste everybody's time looking it up. But, oh, player one. Okay, Beth Harmon. Beth. Wasn't that her name? Beth Harmon? Maybe that's not her name. Beth Harmon, chess player. Elizabeth Harmon, okay. Oh, fictional chess grandmaster. Fictional grandmaster, okay. I mean, is this person a true person? I thought she was a real person. Born 1948. Wow. Okay, so she's a fictional chess grandmaster. Fictional chess grandmaster. Now they're saying this Vera Menchik is the real life Beth Harmon. The real life Beth Harmon. So this article's from almost 2 years ago. So they're saying there was a similar story in real life. The name of the first woman who challenged men in chess was Vera Menchik. And her rise to fame in the deeply patriarchal 1920s and 1930s was even more astounding than that of the fictional Beth Harmon in the 50s and 60s. Okay. So that must have been her right here. Vera Menchik. First woman's world chess champion, and she died during the war, so she was the chess champion for 17 years. Wow, Vera, you were something smart. She paved the way for other women, such as Judith Polgar. She had a difficult childhood in Russia. But she was able to challenge the best men's players in chess. Okay, she was born in 1906. Wow. She was like a little over 20 years older than my dad. Her father was Czechoslovakian, her mother English, but she's born in Moscow. Both her parents worked in Russia. Okay. Yeah, and then she said during the winter of 1919 and 20, the school I attended for some time was without water, heating, or electric light, yet the classes went on. And the students, clad in their fur-lined coats and hats, read by the light of a few flickering candles or an oil lamp. And then perhaps we had an hour's walk home through the snow. For all traffic stopped after working hours. Wow, they had a walk home in the snow. It was in these difficult years that Menchik started to play chess. Her father taught her the rules when she was 9. In 1921, they finally left Russia. Her parents split up. Her father returned to Czechoslovakia. Her mother went to England with the 2 daughters. Okay. So... yeah. The girl said the way the milk bottles were left outside houses in England, that would be impossible in Russia. They would have been stolen in Russia. In England, she took up chess in earnest. And part of the reason was her poor command of the English language. Yeah, she said chess was known for a lot of silence and heavy smoking, and it wasn't really appropriate for a young woman. Okay, 1924, she joined the chess club, put a lot of work into studying chess. She also started taking private lessons. There she is. Wow. So that's basically the Beth Harmon from the Queen's Gambit movie. Yeah, so there was no Elizabeth Harmon or no woman, female chess player from the 50s or 60s that was based loosely on. It was really based on this lady, Vera Menchik. Yeah. So, let's just see if there's any of her chess games in the database. Go to more. Library. We'll just see. Games database. See if they have any Vera Menchik. Why did it not? Really? Vera Menchik. Okay. Born in 1906. Wow, she died when she was 38. That's young. Born in Moscow, the Russian Empire, Federation Russia. But actually, she was English and Czechoslovakian. But, She only won 25% of her games. She won 27% of the time as white, 23% as black. But she played a lot of men. Okay. So, this is her. And they think she would have been rated around 2350. That's good to know. 1939, maybe that's when they... I wonder if they have any of her older games. See how far back her games go. That's 1935, okay. So 1939 was her last games. Hmm. I mean, she doesn't really have that great a win percentage. 25%. A draw, 24%, a lot. But she kept playing. But I guess she was really good. For a woman, for back then. 1939. She died in 1944. These games are from 1939 was the most recent. Let's just see this one. Looks like she won this one. We'll just quickly scan through it. So they think it was sometime in 1936. Black won. Okay, 0-1, that means black won. She's playing as black. And they played in Czechoslovakia. Let's see the computer analysis. So she's playing someone rated 100 over her. About 100 over her. Okay, so black's accuracy was 86.3, white was 81.5. Yeah, Vera had two great moves. She found the best move 25 times. Excellent 13, good 12, book 3, only 4 inaccuracies, only 3 mistakes compared to her opponent's 7, and her opponent's 9 inaccuracies. She had 1 blunder. Says that was a serious game. How many moves is it? Yeah, it's a lot of moves. 64 moves. Let's just see her great move. Okay. Yeah, she's playing as black. What'd she do? Yeah, I mean, she took it. Since we're in here and she won the game. Wow, she opened with the knight. She didn't even push a pawn up. She pushed a pawn up. Why didn't the knight just take the other knight? That's what I'd like to know. But they said that's best. So remember, Vera's black. Close game right now. Very close. Look. Wow. It's dead even after 21 moves. See? Dead even on the eval bar. The opponent's up one pawn. She didn't take that right there. This moves the bishop to a more active square, making it gain scope. Yeah. But why not just take it? I mean, you could take that for free. Okay, so what if you do this? Oh, okay. Is it frozen now? So, I would just, I mean, like, I would want to take that. What's it say on that? It says it's good, but bishop to c7 was better. And she saw that. Wow. Hmm. But it was still good, but the better move was the other thing. We'll go to the next key move. Can't take that knight because that pawn's there. Oh, this is the best there. Yeah, I just, because this pawn would take back. So, White resigned. White resigned there. Okay, well played. Good job. We learned about Vera Menchik. So, we learned about Vera Menchik today. I'd never heard of her. I'm sure a lot of you haven't either. Bye-bye. Take care. God bless. Stay safe. Have a good week.